Today, the court heard how, in 2016, former Attorney General Mohamed Apandi Ali cleared Najib Razak of wrongdoing over the 1MDB scandal. But in a 1MDB task force meeting in 2015, then-MACC Chief Abu Kassim had said that the former Prime Minister could be charged for the SRC International case. By the Malaysian Insight, this is The People versus Najib Razak. Follow us into the courtroom where it all happens. I'm Patrick Teo. It's Monday, March the 9th. Najib stepped out of his black sedan wearing a dark blue suit with a red and blue striped tie. His expression was blank as he was met by his usual group of supporters at the court's entrance. At 9:30 a.m. sharp, Judge Naslan entered the courtroom and Najib took his seat in the accused dock. Despite a short trial day, three witnesses took the stand, starting with ex-MACC chief Latifa Koya. She had resigned from the top post in the anti-graft agency last Friday. But first, lawyers Sitam and Shafi argued for about half an hour on whether it was necessary to call Latifa back to the stand. Since the MACC audio clips were inadmissible in court, Sitam said it would be, quote, irrelevant, unquote, to continue questioning the witness. The recordings, nine in total, showed Najib allegedly conspiring with top government officials and certain Emirati individuals over 1MDB. These included the former PM seeking to arrange a loan to disguise acts of money laundering in order to help his stepson, Riza Aziz. After hearing both sides, Judge Naslan decided to allow Shafi to continue questioning Latifa. The defense lawyer wanted to know about the intelligence division in the MACC and whether it was true that just 3 weeks before the audio clips were released, an officer from the intelligence branch was transferred somewhere else. Latifa told the court that transfers happened in the MACC all the time, so she was unable to pinpoint who and when. Sitam stopped Shafi. The prosecutor told the judge that Shafi's questioning seemed like a fishing expedition by the defense team for Najib's other court cases and not SRC. With an angry tone, Sitam told the judge, quote, if these issues arise before another trial, it should be brought up before that other trial, not make us sit through it here, unquote. However, Shafi persisted and took the court by surprise when he said he knew what transpired in the anti-graft agency leading up to the release of the recordings. The lawyer said this line of questioning may just open up a, quote, Pandora's box, unquote. He said if Latifa can call the recordings a, quote, criminal conspiracy at the highest level, unquote, then he wanted to know what happened at the highest level of the MACC in this matter. Shafi circled back to the MACC's intelligence division and began asking about the methods they employed. However, Latifa replied that she was not compelled by law to expose how they worked. Shafi sarcastically replied, quote, I don't need to know the exact methods, just the protocol, because I already know everything that happened, unquote. But Latifa stood her ground. Judge Naslan agreed and told Shafi to lay off the topic. Shafi then began to ask Latifa about her knowledge of the trial, specifically about KWAP's 4 billion ringgit loan that had been transferred to Switzerland. The lawyer pressed her on this subject, asking a few times, didn't she want to know where the money went? Suddenly, Latifa said, quote, am I being cross-examined or being questioned on the audio recordings? Unquote. She said she was there to answer questions on the audio recordings as per her subpoena. The witness also told the judge that Shafi should not be asking her about recovery of the KWAP's billions as she was not part of the investigation team probing the issue. But Shafi did not give up and started asking Latifa about 1MDB, to which she answered that she cannot reveal anything about an ongoing investigation. Latifa's firm answers eventually angered the lawyer. In an outburst, he told the judge, quote, "Young Arif, I am done with this witness. She is not answering my questions. She is not cooperative," unquote. And with that, Latifa was let go, and the court took a short break. When proceedings resumed, a new witness was called to the stand. It was former Attorney-General Mohamed Apandi Ali. Referring to Apandi's press statement in 2016, Shafi asked the former AG why he had cleared Najib of any wrongdoing in the 1MDB scandal. The witness said he had found no evidence to show that Najib had committed any offence or carried out any corrupt practices, adding that the MACC had also not found anything incriminating the former leader. Apandi said, quote, "It was my understanding that he did not know about the 42 million ringgit in his account. That was why I did not charge him," unquote. He added that he was satisfied that the KWAP loan approval was done properly. With regards to the MACC recordings, the witness had no idea of it and did not sanction it. When Sitam took over from Shafi, he asked Apandi if he knew that after he cleared Najib of wrongdoing, 76 new witnesses were called in and had their statements taken. The witness said he was not aware. Sitam then asked Apandi if he was aware that Najib had admitted to the 42 million ringgit in his account in an affidavit. Apandi said that after January 2016, he had no knowledge of the case. When it was put to the witness that he had instructed the then MACC chief to close the files on Najib, he denied it. Before Apandi was let go from the stand, Shafi was back and asked if he had covered up for the former Prime Minister. Apandi said no. The third defence witness of the day was Raja Gopal, who is Deputy Director for Corporate Investigations in Bukit Aman. He told the court of a meeting with the 1MDB task force at Abdul Ghani Patel's house. He was the AG who preceded Apandi. Raja Gopal attended as a representative of the then Inspector General of Police, Khalid Abubakar. The witness noted that former Bank Negara Governor Zeti Aziz, Zulkifli Ahmad and Abu Kassim from the MACC were among the attendees at the meeting. In the meeting, Abu Kassim, who was MACC chief at the time, had suggested that Najib could be charged for the SRC case. And with that, Raja Gopal was released from the stand and proceedings wrapped up for the day. The hearing continues tomorrow. This podcast is produced, written and mixed by Revati Subramaniam, Yapik Kwan and Amina Farid. I'm Patrick Teo.